Okay, motive for homicide. Yes, for Jennings.
Hold up there, Speedy. You're getting ahead of yourself.
You didn't see the look on Ray's face when he told me what happened.
Yes, but I did listen to every single one of Lieutenant Hall's tapes, and he had his own issues.
Okay, maybe I should hold that marker.
You have to admit, Ray had every reason to kill the lieutenant. If he didn't, six Marines would have been killed trying to rescue one POW.
You're right. I'll give you motive. But Ray's story is also a motive for suicide.
No man left behind. Lieutenant knew he had to attempt the rescue.
Yeah, but that meant leading his men into certain death.
An impossible choice. And he said so himself. In his last tape, he said, I wanted to have it in me to lead, but I don't. I can't carry this anymore.
Boss, what do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah. To which theory?
I see both.
Is there a blizzard, too?
Hey, got something.
Yeah, go. Let's hear it.
Harry Jennings doesn't have any family.
No one he's in contact with, no.
You said that he talked about spending his commissary money.
Right, on books for the library.
Which got me wondering.
Who is sending him money?
Exactly. So I looked into it, and for the last 30 years, there has been an anonymous contributor to Ray's account.
You tracked the deposits?
I did. Through four fake names and two shell companies directly to retired Master Sergeant Thomas Fletcher.
A witness.
Why would he give money to the man that he'll put away for life?
Guilt.
So when are you people...